is Misha Kadigasha. On behalf of Oakland Unified School District, I'm excited to bring everyone together to honor and recognize the hard work and dedication by Martin Luther King Elementary School students and staff. MLK participated in OUSD's district and citywide attendance campaign for the month of February. The theme was Black History Month. Classrooms throughout the district reflected, engaged, and processed the meaning of social and academic quotes from many of our African-American leaders throughout our history. We have a special guest today to present this award, but before we introduce him, I wanted to play a short video of his.
My name is Jesse Byrd. That's Byrd with a Y. I'm from Oakland, California, and I'm a storyteller as well as a designer. Something most people don't know about me is that I like to collect hats from the places my wife and I are fortunate to visit. My dream is to actually have an international haberdashery where I can dress my kids in all of these hats from different countries that are native to different countries and embarrass my wife in public by wearing them to restaurants and things like that. My novel, King Penguin, has won awards at both the Paris and Los Angeles Book Festival, placing top 5 in its category of middle grade novels. My hobbies as a kid, basketball. I love playing basketball. Football, I love playing football as well. Video games for sure. Love playing video games as a kid. Still do. Chess. I would lose a lot, but when I did win, it felt really, really good. Last but not least, definitely reading. It was one of the things, if I wasn't in front of a TV screen, it's probably reading a book, and that's where you could find me indoors. My next project is a picture book about a girl named Martine who's growing up in New Orleans, and she lives in this beautiful Afro-French community that's just been hit by tough times. And she comes and offers some really great perspective and insight to help the community get back on their feet. It's been an adventure getting to know Martine. I think she's a really special young lady. She's been full of surprises for me, and I can't wait for you to meet her too.
Cool. Thank you. As you see, our special guest is an author of children and young adult books, including his award-winning book titled King Penguin, which he was recently elected to the board of the famous National Public Radio board and grew up here in Oakland. It is my pleasure to introduce Oakland's very own Jesse Byrd. And Jesse has performed story time readings of his children's books to over 25,000 kids in over a dozen countries to date and has 2 new books releasing in the next few months. And with that, I would like to welcome Mr. Byrd and have him recognize and congratulate Principal Groves Waters, Community School Manager Mr. Henderson, and Attendance Specialist Ms. Washington, the MLK Attendance Team, and the entire MLK family. Mr. Byrd.
Nice. Thank you so much, Misha. Thank you, Ashley. Thank you, Emily, for inviting me here. So super congratulations to Martin Luther King Jr. Elementary for the attendance award. That is major. Showing up is such a big part of progressing and growing and just becoming who it is that you want to be, showing up for your career, showing up for your work, showing up for your passions. It takes presence. It takes persistence. It takes constant learning. And the first step is just being present and leaning into whatever it is that is a part of your growth cycle. So I really want to congratulate you all, congratulate Martin Luther King Jr. Elementary for this amazing honor. Principal Groves Water, staff, amazing, amazing work, especially during such tough times, such difficult times to bring us all together. So really kudos to you all. And I'm so happy to just, you know, be a fellow Oakland resident native to see this beauty really take place.
Well, first of all, thank you all for recognizing Martin Luther King Elementary School. The team worked so hard to really connect with families. And I know Samuel and his mom, they've been great at coming to our school and just being supportive. So welcome, family. And hi, Samuel. Really great kid and student. And thank you, Mr. Byrd, for joining us and, you know, being a part of the school community. We're going to show this video on Monday to all of our faculty and staff, so they'll get a chance to review it, and we'll have it in our archive on our website so that families can see it as well, and we'll send it to everyone. So thank you. We're grateful. The whole team, George Henderson leads our attendance team, along with our attendance clerk, Miss Emma Washington, and then our school secretary, she joins us, Miss Watkins, and then we have our TSAs, Dr. Malloy, Miss Hendon, Miss Cho. We work together every week to see which families we want to focus, to see which families need the best support to help them make sure that their kids are online. And I can't do this without them. So they come in, we do home. We even walk to folks' homes. Hey, how can we get you to come to school? What can we do to support you? Ms. Watkins, our school secretary and attendance clerk and another team member, parent liaison, I forgot Ms. Tony, can't forget her. They station themselves at the schools to say, hey, parents, come on in. Even Mr. Henderson, we'll teach you how to get on a computer. We'll show you what to do. And we're just very thankful for this opportunity. Thank you for the award. We're very thankful. Curtis, thank you for working with us. He showed us best practices and strategies that really help us. We'll take the idea that he has and, we'll run with it. And we appreciate that kind of support from our attendance team. So thank you, team. Appreciate you very much.
And we know the hard work that it takes for anybody working in school sites, the amount of work it takes, and especially in the conditions that we have now. And so all of us are here to serve and support you all who are working at the school sites, because that you are the ones who are implementing the real work. So thank you. And again, congratulations. Let's see that that traveling trophy, that clock. And so yes, that's MLK's traveling trophy. It's a clock. You show the other side. It's about showing up on time. It's meant just for Oakland Unified. And we're happy that it's housed at MLK this month. And with that, Mr. Byrd, I'm gonna actually ask if I can ask a couple questions for you. And then we'll turn it over to students or staff if they have any questions.
Absolutely, let's do it.
What does showing up every day mean to you?
Oh yeah, showing up every day is still so important for me. And the way that I show up in my career as a storyteller is by making sure that I write a little bit every day, that I read some every day, and that I look at reading to learn from other people who are working in my craft who have come before me and learn how they handle story issues or character development, all the elements that go into story. And also I get to look at a whole lot of art because I work in children's picture books like the artwork behind me. So this is from one of our books. And so I really look at a lot of art to see which artists may be right to pair with for a particular story, because I can't draw worth a lick. So if any of you students love to draw, paint, and color, maybe you can help me make a book one day, because I won't be the one drawing it. I do the writing side. And so that's what showing up looks like to me, even as an adult. And so it never really stops. You just carry it over into your profession and your passion, showing up for your community and for your family and whatever it is that you hold dear. But being present is so important. It's irreplaceable.
Awesome, thank you. Next, if you could have a conversation with your elementary school self, what advice or encouragement would you give yourself?
That's a great question. I would say not only show up, but lean in. I think the first step is being present. The second step is being engaged. It's your time. You're here anyway. You might as well get the most out of your time, because time is something you can never get back. It's something you'll never replace. And as you get older, you get to get more and more familiar with that truth. And so what I would have told my younger self is really like lean in. You're here. Like, everybody's here to try to foster your growth, the teachers, the principals, the parents. And so, really lean into that and get the most juice for the squeeze, because it's only going to carry you further and further down the line and what you eventually want to do as you get older and older.
Awesome. Thank you. And last one for me. Is there a specific subject, a moment, a person from your elementary school days that you would like to that helped shape who you are today?
Yeah, so the first transformational teacher that I had in my life was Mrs. Allen, a third grade teacher at St. Leo's Elementary across the street from Fenton's. And she just made it so fun and engaging. She had so much spunk and pizzazz, and her enthusiasm for what it is she wanted to share with us in terms of teaching translated, and we could feel that energy. And that was the first time I was introduced to the notion that school can be this electric, learning can be this electric process that really can light you up, and that people can share what they're passionate about with you in a way that at least helps you appreciate their passion, even if those aren't the subjects or the professions you want to go into later in life, it's just the energy that translates. And so that is the one person that sticks out first. And then of course, in high school, Mr. Tony Green at Bishop O'Dowd. But yeah, first and foremost, it was Mrs. Allen, third grade.
Energy and motivation is important. We see it in you still today, even being with us here today. So yeah, if we see them again, thank us for them.
No doubt.
All right. Any students or staff from MLK want to have any questions for Mr. Byrd?
We plan reading his book.
He said, we plan on checking out your books.
Oh, nice, nice. Thank you so much, buddy. I appreciate that. And I failed to mention a little bit earlier for MLK winning the award this month, I'm actually going to send a completely signed set to the school. So you all will have your own signed, personalized set as just a little token of gratitude from, you know, your fellow Oakland guy and what is an amazing accomplishment. So we'll get those in the mail.
Amazing. We're going to follow up on that. We love books at the school.
Again, I would like to congratulate the whole entire MLK community, especially the students and the staff who work so hard at attending school every day. I want to thank you, Mr. Byrd, for representing today and taking your time out and even making the offering of, you know, the books and supporting the literacy through your work with the school is invaluable. We greatly appreciate it. And with that, I want to encourage and wish that everybody have a safe and supportive weekend. Do as much reading as you can. Take care of yourself. And congratulations, MLK, again. Everyone take care.